I would just like to give a brief introduction about me. So my name is Shivam, and I'm working in Koenig. I'm working as a corporate trainer here at Koenig Solutions. I am having eight plus years of experience in training and capacity building. And if I talk about my certification, so I have completed my EC Council SOC Analyst certification. Apart from that, I have covered Cybersecurity Analyst, CompTIA Security Plus, CompTIA IT Fundamentals Plus. Apart from this, I have covered the ISO courses as well, 27001, that talks about ISMS. Then we had, I have covered the courses like Energy Management System, Asset Management System, 55001, 31001 Risk Management System. So I have covered these many courses, and these many courses are, I'm basically responsible for instructing for these courses. And if I talk about my experience, so I have dealt with the client, I have trained the clients throughout the globe, and I'll be very happy to be the part of this. I'm very happy to be the part of this whole training process. So if I talk about SOC, basically, so it's basically it's an intermediary level course where we will be going through, we'll be letting through the important basic things about the security operations center. Okay. Okay, so it's about it was about me. And if I talk about my ongoing certification, so I am currently working in PCI DSS, payment card industry data security standard, and I'm currently working in CRISC. Apart from that, I'm also preparing for ISO 9001 quality management system, QMS. So these are my ongoing upgrades that I'm working currently, and hopefully I'll be completing them very soon. So it's about me. So to start with, let me just let you through the important parts of the SOC analyst. So first thing is that you will be getting one account. You have to create one Aspen account. Okay, so this is the interface of the Aspen account. Okay, let me just show it from the beginning. Okay, so this when you will just log into your Aspen account. So this Aspen account is for you to go through the training material. Okay, so once you get, that's the reason I just asked that whether you have got the courseware code or not. Okay, so what you have to do, you have to go through, you have to just log in, you have to create one Aspen account, and in the Aspen account you have to insert the promo code, the code you will be getting from the Koenig. Anthony and Henry will be providing the same. Okay, so you have to do what you have to do. You have to just click on the promo code. So you have to just enter the promo code. Once you enter the promo code, this interface will be like this. Okay, certified SOC analyst. So the training, evaluation, exam, certificate, status, all these things will be visible like this. Okay, and in this first case, if I talk about this first case, so this is it is all completed. Okay, the person has passed. It the status is active. Okay, see, once you will get into, so everything will be shown as pending. Okay, so you have to complete each and everything, and then you can just go through. You can just complete it. Okay, so when you will put the promo code over there, so this interface will look like this. And after that, you will just, when you click into trainings, my trainings, so this will be the, these are the lessons that, these are the basically the modules that we are going to cover. Okay, so there is ebook. So this ebook, if I talk about this ebook, so this ebook is non-downloadable. You cannot download it. Okay, it is something that you have to go through using the internet in the browser only. Okay. So when you click on this, so this is the student material basically, which I am just showing. This will be the same interface for you. Okay. So this will be like this. Okay. So there will be six chapters. You can just go through these chapters. Okay. You can go through the chapters. There will be different chapters. There will be different sub-modules within the chapters. Okay. So you can just go through them. So that is the reason I just asked that whether you have got the courseware code and the lab code or not, because the code will be different. The courseware code will be different and the lab course will be different. Okay. So the salespersons will be, salespeople will be responsible for that. Okay. So I hope that they will be providing the same by the end of the day or by tomorrow, I guess. So with this, let's start our session now. Okay. So when we talk about the SOC, okay, so I would just like to know about, it's the certifying agency here is EC Council. Okay, so we will be covering six modules throughout the chapter, throughout the certification, without throughout the training. The first one is the security operations and management. Then comes understanding the cyber threats. IOCs. IOCs means indicators of compromise. Okay, and attack methodology, incident events and logging. Fourth one, we are going to talk about the incident detection with security information and event management, enhanced incident detection with threat, and the sixth module is the incident response. So these are the six modules that we are going to cover in the course of 3 days. So what I am planning that we will be covering two modules per day, okay, making it six modules in 3 days. And whatever is convenient, we will just quickly go through the same. And what my training methodology is, that we learn more when we discuss. So I have always been through this way that we do not go it monotonous. Okay, we will be discussing the things throughout. Okay, so what happens that most of the doubts get cleared when we discuss it. Okay, because whenever we are discussing in the training, it's about collaborative learning. Collaborative learning means I'm learning from you, you are learning from me. Okay, so I'm also in a way to learn new things, because we have got professionals from the different field, from the different countries. So it's all being a win-win situation over there. Okay. Okay. So we have already done the introduction. So what is CSA program? So if I talk about the CSA, the SOC analyst program is designed to bring people, process and technology together and provide a comprehensive skill set to manage a robust security operations center with enhanced incident detection and responsible capabilities. Then comes the program takes a holistic approach in training an individual right from the understanding from various attack methodologies to collaborate with IRTs in case of the incident. IRT means incident response team. So what we are going to see through the whole chapters, or we can see what we are going to go through the whole modules, is that what are the basic terms and terminologies. As LADA is new to this, okay, so what I'll be doing, I'll be covering it from the scratch. And in case LADA you are having any sort of doubt, do not hesitate in asking the doubt. Okay, the same is for the Fito Gang as well. If there is any sort of doubt, any confusion, please stop me, interrupt me. It's never like that. If you will interrupt me during this, what if I'm saying something, please do interrupt me and please do clarify your doubts. Okay, I'll be more than happy to clarify all your doubts, and I'll try my best to provide you the best you have opted for. Okay.
No problem.
Okay, so here we have, it will help students to gain in-depth knowledge to understand the relationship between the events, logs, incident, and provide appropriate skills to manage various SOC processes, centralized log management, CLM, SIEM use, case development, alert triage, and the incident response. So it's about the CSA program, the Certified SOC Analyst program. Okay, so these are the six chapters that we are going to discuss. These are the different modules basically. Okay. So we are, these are the additional reference material. Okay. So that will be available in your Aspen portal. Okay. But I think that as you both have opted for the official lab, so you won't be requiring anything. Okay. There will be, I'll be just sharing once I get the credentials. Okay. I'll be sharing the same with you off the records. Okay. Off the records means when the session gets over, I'll be sharing the details. I'll be sharing one of the that how the labs will be there. I'll be sharing the whole interface with you, so that when you receive the code, you will be able to do it by your own. You won't be requiring any of my guidance. Okay. Because, okay. So if I talk about the exam information, so exam title is Certified SOC Analyst. Exam code is 31239. The number of questions will be 100. The duration will be 3 hours, and it will be available on ECC exam portal. The ECC exam portal is the similar one. What you have to do when you will go for the exam, when you will click on the exam here. So this is your ECC exam center, okay? EC Council exam center. So here you have to put your username, you have to put the password. And this examination is basically done through, online proctoring. So once you say that you are prepared for the examination, so there will be one online proctor and invigilator will be there who will be looking you throughout the course of the examination. Okay, making sure that you are there in the secluded environment and your computer, your machine is having all the appropriate technical specification that is required. Okay, so this examination is going to be online proctored. Okay, the passing score is 70%. That out of that you have to get 70%. You have to get minimum 70% in order to clear the examination. Okay, so the training instructor will advise you for the exam schedule and the voucher details. Okay, so the voucher, if you have opted for the examination, then you will be getting a voucher, and then when you will get that voucher, you will be using the same in your Aspen account, and you will be able to schedule your examination. Or I'll be sharing one of the email IDs here at Koenig. Whenever you are planning for going through the examination, or when you are planning to sit for the examination, you can email to that email ID, and the people will be there to guide you throughout. Okay. Henry and Anthony, your customer experience manager, they will be there throughout. Whenever you feel like, you can just go on and you can just ask your doubts to them. And if I talk about me, so you can also share your doubts even when the course is complete, even when the training is completed, you can just reach out to me. I'll be sharing my WhatsApp and I'll be sharing my email ID with you, Pitogang and Lada. At any point of time, you feel like there is some difficulty or there is some sort of confusion, you can reach out to me anytime. Okay. I'll be more than happy to help you out with. Okay. So don't worry that after the training is over, you will be not able to contact me. No, it's never like that. I'll be available for you. Okay, all you need to do is just ping me on WhatsApp, or you can just email me. Okay, there is a possibility if I am there in a batch, then there is a possibility that I might respond your mail, or I may not instantly respond, but shortly I'll respond. Okay. Okay, so this is about the examination. Let me just let you through. Okay. This is the
I have feedback here from Henry. On my side, he's saying, so I have the whole package prepared for me. The labs, he's saying they will be already shortly. The courseware and exam was part of the package and will be shared with you by tomorrow, positively.
Okay. That is the reason I just made sure that what is going on. Okay, so that's really good that you will be having all the things. I think the same will be with the LADA as well. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If in case you have not opted for the examination, that is not a big picture. Okay. The thing that we have to make sure is that you are getting the courseware and the lab access as soon as possible so that you can try the labs on your own. Okay. Once you go mm-hmm. through, because the whole interface is there, you don't have to download anything. The good thing about the labs here in EC Council is that you don't have to download anything. It's all there. It's the built-in environment mm-hmm. in the website only. So you have to just follow the instructions and do what is directed over there, and you will be going through the whole things. Make sense?
Mm-hmm.
Sivam.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, yeah, Fetugan.
For how long will the content be available for us? How long does it take?
Okay, so the date is once you get the code, and after you redeem the code, 1 year validity is there. Okay, and I'll be just checking it once again with the courseware team to make sure that whether the same has been extended or not. But as of now, as per my, because what happens, Fetugang and Lara, these people, this EC Council, all Comshia, they keep on changing the things very frequently. Okay, mm-hmm. So that is the reason, as per my latest knowledge, it was 1 year, but there is a possibility, there might be a possibility that they might have extended it as well. So I'll just check and I'll be just coming back with more concrete information. But as of now, 1 year validity is there. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Does it answer your question, Fetugan?
Yes, you did.
Okay. So it's about the examination. So the lab sessions are designed to reinforce the classroom sessions. So the sessions are intended to give a hands-on experience only and does not guarantee proficiency. It's like they prepare an environment and they will give you a hands-on experience. So as there are labs, so, you know, it becomes very difficult to go through each and every session of the labs. So that is the reason the labs will be provided, and whenever and after going through the sessions, you can just go through the labs, you can just do the hands-on practice, and you will be proficient in that. Okay.
Okay.
So let's move forward. So these are the virtual machines which will be available in your lab environment. The Kali Linux, DMZ, internal network. Okay. So these will be there in your these all virtual machines will be available in your labs. So you don't have to download anything, you don't have to install anything, you just have to log in, and you have to just launch it. And once you launch it, there will be instructions over there. You have to follow the instructions and the result will be there in front of you. So it's very easy and very interactive, the lab sessions. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Okay, so CSA contain multiple virtual labs to stimulate a real-life complex network environment. So it's like these are the virtual machines, the Kali Linux, SIEM, okay, Windows 10, SIEM 2, okay. So let's quickly go through the module number one. So module number one talks about security operations and management. Okay, so the objective of this module is to understand that how SOC contributes to the organization security management and its effort to maintain a good security posture of the organization. So the security management in the organization and the security activities involved in the security management. So different aspects of the security operations, basic concepts of SOC, different phases involved in the implementation of SOC, challenges of the SOC implementation, SOC key performance indicators, KPIs and metrics, best practices, and the difference between SOC and NOC. So we'll be going through all of these. So the first thing first, security management. So I would just like to ask that, what do you understand by security management? Lada, Fitogang?
Well, from the aspect, I'm always going to refer to the aspects that I do have. So it involves not only the security of our infrastructure, not only of our cloud infrastructure, but also the infrastructure of the application, as well as the security related to the to people and the processes, and of course to the operations that we are handling.
Thank you, Lada. Thank you. Okay. So yeah. Security manage. Yeah, Fitogang, you're saying something.
No, I was saying security management. This will include the infrastructure, the infrastructure is included, the network infrastructures, storage, and the storage, even the cloud, going to the cloud, and then there is, like Lada has just said, people, security. And then in our case, we also have physical security.
Exactly. Yes.
Yeah. Physical security include people security, the policies that are there that enforces those policies.
Okay, thank you so much. So yes, security management is basically the collection, as Lada and Fitogang, you both have mentioned, that it is a collection of we can say systematic, or we can say repetitive set of interconnected security activities that help organization to maintain their security posture at an adequate level. Okay. So when we talk about security and security management, so it is an ongoing process. Okay, it's never ending process. It's always ongoing, because we never know that when an incident, when an attacker might attack our system, or when the attacker is ready to attack to our network. So it is always an ongoing effort that focuses on both physical safety and the digital security of the assets. So it is very crucial, and we can say very essential part of every organization, whether you be from pharmaceutical industry, whether you be from training industry, whether you be from logistics industry, whether you be from net logistics industry. Okay, the data is the important asset. Okay, whenever we are talking about the security, whenever we are talking about cyber security, so in today's paradigm of the digital, in today's digital paradigm, we can say that the security of the data asset has become a very key aspect, very important aspect. Okay, and whenever we are talking about the security, so one thing is very common that we always talk about, and that is CIA. The whole cybersecurity, whenever we are talking about the security management, okay, whenever we are talking about the security management, whenever we are talking about the security, we are talking about CIA. CIA. So what is CIA? Any idea?
Nope. Okay. From my side, okay. No.
Okay, Lada. Thank you. No worries.
I don't know.
No.
Information.
Okay.
Compliance information.
Okay.
And something else.
All the guesswork over there. Okay.
Chief information analyst.
Okay, I'll just share it. C stands for confidentiality.
Confidentiality, yeah.
Okay.
Confidentiality. I stands for integrity. And A stands for availability.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So whenever we are talking about cybersecurity, we basically focus on these three aspects, C, I, A, and one more thing is there, N. Okay, C, I, A, N. Or many times people, in order to make it concrete in their mind, they basically remember P, A, I, N. Okay, so I'll just let you through. I'll just forget this P, A, I, N as of now. Just focus on C, I, A, confidentiality, integrity, availability. C, I, A, and N stands for principle of non-repudiation. Don't worry. I'll be just going through all of these concepts right now. So the first thing is confidentiality. So to proceed with, I would just like to ask that what do you understand by confidentiality? What do you understand by confidentiality?
Well,
I would say confidentiality is sharing between relevant sources, or only shared between relevant sources,
okay,
or relevant personnel who are supposed to have that information.
Exactly. Okay, thank you. Thank you, Fitagan. Any response from you, Lada?
Well, from my point of view, it's the confidentiality of the data, residuing, and whether it's residuing or it's data in rest or data in transition, as well as confidentiality regarding the to the all as well to the metadata as well.
Okay. Thank you so much. So yes, basically, thank you Lada and Fitagang for your responses. So when we talk about the security management, so the main purpose is to protect the organization's assets, the data assets. So it basically ensures confidentiality, integrity, availability, and non-repudiation. These are the principles of confidentiality, integrity, availability, and non-repudiation. So security management also develops and implements the various documents like policies, standards, procedures, and guidelines. That basically helps that how we are going to implement it in order to provide CIA, in order to make sure that CIAN is intact within the organization. So when I talk about confidentiality, so I'll be giving you one example. Confidentiality means my data is accessible to me. Okay, my data is accessible to me. For example, confidentiality, it means that I'm having my mail ID. Okay, I'm having my mail ID. I'm having a password. I'm just putting in there. And when I log into my email ID, so it should be like that I'll be able to see my emails, and I'll be able to see the emails which others have sent. And those emails are intended for me. For example, Lada has shared an email that, okay, I have to share one email to Shivam. So Lada has sent me an email. And when I log into my account, I'm able to see that Lada has shared me an email. Okay, so that email is intended for me. As it is intended for me, so it is received by me. And it is me, it is Shivam, who is intended or who is supposed to see that email. Okay, so that is known as confidentiality, that the information, if I am sharing any information to Lada, if I am sharing any information to Fitagang, for example, your codes, okay, your subscription codes, for example, that we were discussing few minutes back. Okay, so the codes will be, it's never like that the same code will be available, same code is applicable to both Lada and Fitagang. No, the codes will be different. The courseware code for Lada and the courseware code for Fitagang will be different. The lab access code for Lada and lab access code for Fitagang will be different. So what I have to do, I have to share those emails separately. In case I'm sharing it, I'm just giving an example. I have to share it separately. And it should be like that the codes that I'm sharing for Lada, it should be visible and it should be accessible. And it should be intended. It is intended for Lada, and same goes for Fitagang. So confidentiality means that the privacy, or many times confident people we always, many times what happens, we also call it as privacy. Confidentiality uh-huh. is also known as privacy. That
yes.
Lada is able to see the emails, what are intended for Lada. Shivam is able to see the emails, what are intended for Shivam. Fitogang is able to see the emails that what are intended for Fitogang. For example, I am here, I am sharing one case study to Fitogang. And I have shared to Fitogang saying that Fitogang, it is only for you. And you have to make it, make any changes. For example, I am sharing one document, one cloud document to Fitogang. And I'm asking that Fitogang, whatever, for I'm just giving an example, okay? That what are the course requirements you are having even after CSA, so you can just put in there. So I'll share that document with Fitogang and Fitogang will log into his email ID. He will click on that document. He will make those changes and he will share it back to me. So that document was intended for Fitogang. It is the authorized personnel to edit that document was Fitogang. So Fitogang was able to edit the document and he shared it back to me. So in case I'm able to see that there some editing has been done by Fitogang, so that is intended for Fitogang and I am the one who was the owner of that document. So I can also do some changes and send it back to Fitogang. So it is between me and Fitogang. There is no one in between. Okay. Mm-hmm. So that is confidentiality. That if anything is being shared, okay, it should go to that intended person only. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm sharing some document, okay. So there are various controls that I can put in over there. Okay. That who mm-hmm. can see the document, who can download the document, who can edit the document, who can forward the document. So it is upon me. So the person I am the one who will be deciding that whom should see what. In the same case as you, you are the ones, if you are sharing any information to anyone, so it simply means that information is intended for that person only and it is intended for no one else. Is it clear?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Then
so it has also to do, sorry, it has also to do with the access controls.
It has also to do with the access control, that whom you are, what you are sharing to someone and whom is intended to see that and whom can do any changes in that. So that is CIAN. So C stands for confidentiality and it is also known as privacy. Then we talk about I. So it is clear, confidentiality?
Yes.
Okay. Lada, yes. Is it clear? Any doubt?
Yes, yes, it's clear.
Okay. Then we talk about integrity. Integrity. Integrity, any doubt, any idea about integrity, Lada and Fitogang?
Integrity is the, how should I put it? The word disappeared. Integrity, it should be from the integrity, it should be true or it should be correct.
Mm-hmm.
And how do I put it?
Okay, no worries.
Mm.
No worries. Any input Lada. From you, Lada?
Lada?
Yeah. From my perspective, it should be the content. So the content must be true
mm-hmm.
and intact. So the data should be true and not, messed around with or anything mm-hmm. shouldn't it should be intact.
Exactly. It's very close, Lada. Thank you, Lada, and thank you, Peter Gang. Exactly. Integrity simply means that the data does not get changed. Okay.
Yeah.
Data does not get changed. If I am sharing one message to, we are here in the class. Okay, we are here in the class, and I am sharing hi. Hi, how are you? For example, I am sharing an email, sharing that hi, how are you? I have just let me make it more clear because it's all cluttered over there. Okay, so when I say hi, how are you? Okay, so if I'm sharing that this email, this thing is there in my mail body, that hi, how are you, then it should go as it is. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
For example, if I'm putting hi, comma, how are you? And I have put three question marks. Okay, so hi, then we have comma, how are you? I'm sharing this statement in an email to Lada and Peto Gang. Okay, for example. Okay, so the principle of integrity says that this whole statement should go as it is. As it is means hi, if there is written hi, hi. So it should go as it is. If h is capitals, okay, if it is in uppercase, it should go as it is. How are you? And if there are three question marks at the end of the statement, it should go as it is. So principle of integrity. The principle of integrity says that the data should reach to the other end, or whenever the data is going through the destination, it should not like anything is between which has changed the data or anything has altered the data. The data should go as it is. Okay. If the data gets altered at any point in between or in the medium, then that is considered as the violation of integrity principle. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So that is the reason. The second principle says that the data should go as it is. There should be no changes in the data. And if changes are there in the data, one more point, if there are changes in the data, then those changes should be made by the intended personal only. For example, I gave you the example that I'm sharing one sheet to both Lada and Fitogang. And when I have shared that sheet, it is in some format. Okay. And I have asked Lada and Fitogang to edit on that sheet, do some editing, put your views or put something over there. Okay. Your preferences or something, any data. So it is me, Lada, and Fitogang who can do changes in that document. It is not authorized for Anthony. It is not authorized for Henry who can see that data and they can edit that data. So the principle of integrity says that the data should go as it is, and if there are any changes, and there should be no change in the data, and if there are changes in the data, then we have to make sure that those changes are made by intended or authorized personnel only. Does it make sense?
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, it does.
Okay. Thank you. And the last, then we have, then we have got the principle of availability. Why is availability important?
Availability, I would say it's important because if you are if you are to access your email or some file in the database that you intend to use maybe in your daily work. If availability is disrupted, it means you won't be able to work. So therefore, availability, I will say, is having access to whatever that you are needing.
Exactly.
At that particular time when you want to access it.
Great. Thank you so much, Fatogang. Any inputs from you?
No, I think that Fatogang actually covered it quite well. From my side, I would say for its accessibility to certain data, but to be available as it is at a certain point of time or as predefined for that data.
Okay, that's great.
I think LADA has captured another important aspect. The aspect of accessibility as on its form. It shouldn't have been whenever it's needed.
Exactly. So summarizing both of your inputs, that yes, what is availability? Availability means that any resource, any document, any information, any data, it should be available to the intended or the authorized personnel whenever it is required. Okay, let me just share one, just a minute. Okay. Okay, availability time. Let me just make it that way. Just a minute. Yeah. So this image will cover most of the things. Okay. So whenever any organization or whenever we can say any website is saying that it is available 99.999% of time, it means that the information, whatever they are hosting there in their website. Okay. Mm-hmm. So downtime, what do you understand by downtime?
Downtime is something that you cannot access the content for a certain period of time.
Exactly. So whenever we are saying that the availability is 99%. So whenever a downtime is calculated, it is calculated on yearly basis, on monthly basis, on weekly basis, and on day basis. So if any organization is saying that they are available 99% of time, so it means that there is downtime of 14.4 minutes in a day. Downtime in a week is 101.77 minutes in a week. In a month, the downtime is 7.3 hours. In an year, the downtime is 87.6 hours. Downtime is there in a year whenever an organization is saying that they are providing 99% of availability. So when we talk about availability, we are talking about business. Okay. If the information is not available for the intended personnel, then what will happen? It will harm the business. It will harm the reputation of the organization. So that is the reason most of the time organizations, they pay. You won't believe that going from 99% availability to 99.99% availability, they have to pay a lot of dollars. Okay, because this is something that creates the difference between the competitors. Okay. This is something that creates a lot of difference. See, in 99.999% availability, there is a downtime of 5.256 minutes in a year. Okay. And when we talk about 0.999%, what is the difference between 0.999% in a year? That is 87.6 hours and 5.256 minutes. So availability is a very crucial, we can say, aspect that every organization looks for, that every organization takes care of. Okay. Mm-hmm. Because a downtime means loss in the business. Mm-hmm. If there is a downtime, there will be a loss in a business. I'll let me give you one example of Microsoft Teams. So recently, 1.5 months back, and previously in the month of July or June, the Microsoft Teams was not available for 2 hours. It was not available for 2 hours globally. So it means mm-hmm. that it was a revenue loss for Microsoft, because most of the organization, they rely on their meetings on Microsoft Teams. So mm-hmm. when a service is not available, that results to revenue loss, that results to reputation loss, that results to business loss, that results to lost reputation. So that is mm-hmm. the reason availability is a very, very, very serious constraint that we have to make sure that we are there. Okay, that the information, that the data, or the information, data, website, portal that is available to the intended users all the time. It should not be like that. Okay, it is 12 a.m. in the morning. Okay, or there is 1 a.m. in the morning. Okay, so you cannot access it. It should be accessible to you if you are the intended user. As it is, very simple. Make sense?
Yes.
Yeah, it sure. is.
So we have covered confidentiality, integrity, availability.
Yes.
Yeah.